Welcome to eMedia Coach. I am your expert instructor for the AstraPro theme, and in today's video I am going to talk to you about the spacing feature of the AstraPro module. So before we begin this video, if you haven't bought the AstraPro theme yet and if you are using the free version of the Astra, then you can go to emediacoach.com/astra and then you'll be redirected to the Astra's website where you can buy the Pro theme. So let's begin the tutorial. So this is the website on which we are going to apply all the features. So let's go to the dashboard of this website. Now once you are logged in, you have to go to appearance and then go to Astra options. Here you'll find all the Pro modules available to the people who have bought the theme. If you are not able to see this activate button here, then you need to buy the Pro version of the theme from Astra's website, or you can also check the link in the description. So in this video I'm going to talk to you about the spacing feature. So before activating this feature, let me show you what is the difference it is going to make. So let's go to the customize here, and in customize, in the layout section, you'll see that there are a lot many of layouts on which we can do editing. So if I go to header, I can see that there are a lot many options here, but there is no option to adjust the spacing of these things. There's no option to edit the padding or spacing or these things related to spacing. So let's go here and activate this spacing feature. And now once I activate this, you'll see that all those features will appear here. So let's refresh this. So now let's go to layout and go to header and then go to site identity. Now when I scroll down, I'll see a spacing feature here which was not available earlier. So if I increase the size here, suppose I keep it 100, you'll see that a space of 100 has been added here. Similarly, I can reduce the space to anything I want. And similarly, I can add the spacing to the right as well, to the bottom as well, and to the left as well. You can also switch it to the percent instead of pixel, so that it will be adjusted in percent section. And if you want to change it for the mobile, then you can just click this icon here and choose it in the tablet. So if I choose in the tablet mode something like this, and in the mobile version I can choose something like. So this is how you can edit it. Now let's go back and then go to primary header. Here also you'll find a spacing option using which you can edit these things. So let's choose the desktop version. So as you can see, I can edit everything using this. And similarly, I can add a spacing to specific to menu. So suppose I add 50 here, you'll see that the menu will be shifted 50 more. And similarly, I can add a spacing to the submenu as well. So as you can see, the submenu spacing can be adjusted using this feature. So this is how you can edit all of this. And now let's go to blog. And before going to blog, let's go to the blog page actually. So you can see in real time that how does this looks. Now let's go to blog and Archer. When you scroll down, you'll find a spacing button here. So there's an option of space outside post. So suppose if I make it 50, so as you can see that this thing has shifted a little below, and if I make it 100, it has shifted even more. Similarly, I can add it to all of the sections here. So as you can see, it is 100 from here, 100 from here, and 100 from here as well, but since there is no space left, it is behaving this way. Similarly, you can add a spacing inside of the post as well. So if I add 50 here, you'll see that this is shifted to 50, and if I make it like 100, this is shifted even more. So you can adjust this space here, and you can also adjust this space here, inner space as well as outer space. Now let's go back. So now let's So now let's go to the sidebar, and in sidebar, when you scroll down, you'll find these options here to adjust the space outside the sidebar as well as inside the sidebar. So suppose I make it 10, you'll see that the space here has been shrunk to 10. And if I make this also 10, you'll see that this space here will be shrunk. So this is what it means by outside and inside of the sidebar. Similarly, you can do it to all the sections here. So if I make it 10, 10, 10 and 10, 10, 10, you'll see that I change the spacing of the sidebar. So this is how you can edit the spacing of the sidebar. So let's go back, and now let's go to the footer. So let's scroll down in the footer section. So here you'll find two options here, footer widgets and footer bar. So let's enable footer widgets first. And let's go to the footer bar as well. Here you'll find this footer space option. So if you want to edit it, you can just put 30, 30, 30 and 30. You'll see that this space here and this space here has been increased. If you want to see it like more, you can just keep it 100 so that you'll see the real difference. So this is how you can edit everything. Now let's go back and then go to container, and here you'll find spacing options as well. So what is the container? Now container is the container which keeps the data of your website. So this is our website data, and this outer thing is the container which is keeping it. So space outside the container, let's keep it 50 from the top. So as you can see that this space has been decreased to 50. If I make it 10, you'll see a big difference there. Similarly you can edit the inside container space as well. So if I make it 10 here as well, you'll see that this space has also been shrunk. Now some people might get confused between this container and this thing blog, but blog spacing is specific only to the blog page, and else container is applicable to all the pages which are using that container. So this is how you can edit the spacing using the Astra Pro blog module. And I hope you like this video and it is going to help you in understanding the spacing feature of the Astra Pro blog module. I hope it helps you to learn more about Astra Pro and spacing module of the Astra Pro theme. If you want to watch more of videos related to Astra Pro, you can just hit the subscribe button below, because I am going to make more videos related to Astra Pro in the near future, so that you'll be notified whenever you will be uploading a new video. And if you like this video, just press the thumbs icon below. And if you want to ask any questions or if you have any suggestions, you can just comment them below, or you can directly go to our website emediacoach.com and put it in the contact form, so that we will help you in whatever your query is or question is. Thank you for watching this video. See you in the next video.